Like,
at this time, I'd like to.
Holy smokes. You guys got your mics on?
You guys got your mics on?
Apparently.
Is that better?
That sounds like going down anymore.
Ken, you have your. Order the Planning and Zoning regular meeting of January 11th, 2024. Can we all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, in the event of a fire, you can exit the rear of the chambers and down the stairs and a safe distance away from the building, or exit to the side doors, go down one flight of stairs and out the back of the building a safe distance. At this time, roll call, please.
Will that be for me? Who's going to be doing the roll call, Ken?
You can, yeah, you can, John.
Okay, all right. Francis Alimo?
Here.
Linda DeGray.
Linda DeGray.
Here.
Here.
Ken Holinski.
Here.
Benny Garolo.
Benny Garolo.
Here.
Joseph Mulway.
Here.
Terrence Lynch.
Here.
John Petronella is here. Christian D'Antonio.
Here.
Pat Hooper.
Here.
And Walter Krizel.
Here.
And Mayor Ken Nelson.
Here. Okay, thank you. Moving on. At this time, we'd like to do election of officers and the review of bylaws. So we will start with a nomination for chairman of planning and zoning. Do I have a nomination?
Yeah. Mr. Chair, Mr. Mayor, Mr. Chair, I'd like to make a nomination for Frank Alimo as chairman.
Okay, a motion for Frank Alimo has been made.
Second.
There's a second. Are there any other nominations? Seeing none, a motion to close
motion
nominations.
Motion to close.
A second?
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. All in favor of closing nominations?
Nominations?
Aye.
Opposed?
Opposed.
Okay, it's unanimous. At this time, a roll call for the nomination for Francis Alimo as chairman of planning and zoning.
Linda DeGray.
Four.
Four.
Ken Holinski.
Four.
Vince Garolo.
Four.
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 Terrence Lynch.
Four.
Four.
John Petronella, Christian D'Antonio,
four.
Pat Hooper,
four.
Four.
Walter Krizel,
four.
Four.
And Francis Limo.
I'm four.
Well, at this time, congratulations. I think you guys are in good hands.
Thank
good
you
luck,
much,
Frank.
Mr. Mayor.
Remember, we represent the people of Enfield, and do your best to work with them and staff.
Let's go.
Here's your cheat sheet as chairman.
Oh, thank you.
There. There's your stuff.
Just get organized here.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Not official.
Oh, oh, okay. I get the seat in Kenny's seat. Okay, just give me a second here. Well, good evening. Very honored to hold this position. I thank Mayor Nelson for your confidence in me and your support, and I hope I can fulfill your expectations. So at this time, we had roll call. I would like to, before we're going to get into the agenda, so I would like to get my paperwork together here. We're going to get into the bylaws. I'm sorry. I just got to find my stuff. Oh, yeah, the election. That's right, too. Okay. Is there a motion for vice chair? Do I hear a motion for vice chair?
One second. John, could you please keep your mic muted? Okay, it is now. Thank you.
I have a cheat sheet here. Am I expecting some of my paperwork still down there?
No, everything is right here.
I'd like to entertain a motion for vice chair, first vice chair, and I'd like to make a nomination for Mr. Lynch, Terrence Lynch. Is there a second?
Second.
Second for Terrence Lynch. All in favor? Any other nominations? Motion to close?
Motion to close my nominations.
Second.
Second.
Roll call, Mr. Secretary, please.
Who made that motion, please? Who made that motion, please?
Okay, we ready?
Okay, we ready?
Roll call, Mr. Chair.
Francis Alendon?
Four.
Linda DeGray?
Against.
Against.
Four.
Joseph Mueller?
Four.
Four.
John Petrolowitz.
Four.
Christian DeAngelo.
Four.
Matt
Hooper.
Four.
And Walter Kurzel.
Four.
That's 9 in favor. I'm sorry, I got some.
That was 9 in favor, 1 against.
That's correct.
Okay, congratulations, Mr. Lynch.
Thank you.
Just so everyone knows, this is not my first opportunity to serve on the planning and zoning. I did so more years ago than I care to admit. So I'm glad to be back, and I'm glad for the council for putting my name forward, and thank you for all your support for my rise to vice chairman. Thank you.
Entertain a motion for second vice chair.
Linda DeGray.
Any other nominations?
I second that nomination.
Any other nominations?
I'd like to nominate Ken Holinsky for second.
I second that. Any other nominations? I'll entertain a motion.
Motion to close nominations.
Motion's closed. Roll call, Mr. Secretary. For Mr. Holinsky.
Yeah, Frank?
Four.
Four.
Linda DeGray?
Linda DeGray.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky.
Quincy Garofalo.
Four.
Four.
Joseph Neely.
Linda DeGray.
Linda DeGray.
Mr. Olinsky.
Mr. Olinsky.
John Petronella. Ken Holinsky.
Four.
And Christian D'Antonio.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky.
Pat Hooper.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky.
Walter Crizell.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky. Four.
Four.
Ken Holinsky.
Okay.
Okay.
Motion passes. With Ken.
Congratulations, Ken.
Congratulations.
Second Vice Chair.
Thank you very much. I'm honored to receive this position on the planning and zoning, and I'll do my best to execute my duties. And I'd like to welcome all of the new members of the Planning and Zoning Commission, and I hope we can all work well together for the people of Enfield. Thank you.
Thank you, Ken.
Thank you, Ken.
Okay.
We're
going to move on.
We're going to move on.
Secretary, I'm sorry.
Motion for
Secretary, please. Entertain a motion.
John Petronella.
I second that. Any other nominations? Make a motion on accept the motion nomination to be closed.
Motion to close.
Second?
Second.
Motions are closed. Roll call, please.
Francis.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Linda DeGray.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Ken Holinsky.
John Petronella.
It's a girl.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Joseph Neely.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Terrence Lynch.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Christian D'Antonio.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Pat Hooper.
John Petronella.
John Petronella.
Walter Crizell.
Four.
Four.
And John Petronella.
Petronella.
John Petronella.
All right, John Petronella is our secretary. Thank you, John. Congratulations. Okay. Go ahead, John.
Best to get another 2 years. And also want to welcome all the new commission members. And with that, I'll turn my mic off.
Okay, moving along. And I'd like, again, to welcome all the new members and look forward to serving with you guys over the next 2 years. Hopefully, we can make some good progress here in town. At this time, before we go any further, we're going to get into the bylaws, the review of the bylaws. So I'd like to entertain a motion to move some agenda items around. So I'd like to entertain a motion to move item 18 to item 10. That's planning staff report. The second one would be to move item 16 to 11. That'd be the correspondence that would come after planning staff report. And then item 17 to item 12. That would be commissioner's correspondence. And I think this is a good spot to do this if I can get a second, and then we'll have discussion.
Second.
Thank you. There's a second.
Thank you. There's a second.
We'll open it for discussion. Normally, I would open it up to the members first, but I'm going to start. Because we still got that mic on.
Mr. Holinsky, please mute.
Okay. Thank you, Ken. Normally I would be opening it up to the members first. I just want to talk about this a little bit, and then we're going to get into the bylaws, and this is also in the bylaws. So these changes would be more in line with the town council and the way they do it, and moving things up in order to make it a smoother flow. So we have the correspondence, we have the public participation, and then the staff report or Lori's report comes at the end of the meeting. So I think it's better for her to have a report while people are still here and their comments are fresh on everybody's mind. And I think that would be a better flow for information. And then the other one, moving the commissioner's correspondence would be in line with that as well. So it would be the public, then Lori or the staff, and then the commission. On correspondence, we have two correspondence items. So one of them says just correspondence. I believe, and I want to talk about, everybody can have their input, I believe that one that says correspondence is from an outside body, another agency, that probably would go to staff and they'd read it to us. The word, it says just correspondence, and then it goes to commissioner's correspondence. It's a little funny on here, the way that is. So I wanted to talk about that as well. And I think, and this is in our bylaws, so we have to do it tonight if we're going to do it, executive session. Executive session is in the agenda, and it's in the regular agenda. It's on item 7 tonight. So, again, I want to uniform what the council does. So if we had executive session tonight, for example, we'd have to clear the room, or we'd all get up and go to another room. And I think it's just interruptive and not fair to, you know, people that are here for applying and the public. So what I think we should do is, again, to follow the council, and if we're going to have an executive session, it should be a separate agenda. The meeting take place in a separate room at 6:30 or 6 o'clock, whatever we think, whatever advice, you know, the town attorney gives us for how long we may need. But so I wanted to put that out there, too. So those are the three things, and we can discuss it. And then when we get to the bylaws, we could, according to bylaws, we have to talk about it tonight, approve it tonight, and then one more meeting, and we can make those changes. And I think the last time the bylaws were amended, revised in 2022, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So I would like to get the commissioner's feelings on this. I know, you know, some of you are new and you're maybe not really catching what I'm saying, but if you watch the council meetings, you'll see that's kind of how they flow. So I'll open it up to first.
On item 16,
mm-hmm.
We've been trying to get rid of that for the longest time.
Planning?
We don't know what that means. It says correspondence. Nobody quite understood what it meant.
Well, that's what was the one I was talking about. Yeah.
And so I don't have.
So what I feel is that that's correspondence from an outside agency, another body of the town government, would go to the town staff. Not to that should be correspondence can stay, and we would say, is there any correspondence? And Lori would say yes or no.
Right, but it's
because we shouldn't, as members, correspond with the public.
It's been there. Nobody quite knows what it's been for years.
And I think
this is nothing
from
new.
Being involved in the Robert's Rules for many, many years, I think that's what is in, the intent is, because we have the two correspondence lines. So I think the intent was, if we'll use the council, the council's got correspondence to us for some reason, that would be the correspondence, or another body of the town. So it probably should stay in case it's needed, but we'll just go by right by it. But it's nothing for us. It's nothing for us to come up with. It'd be staff. And Lori, you want to have your input on just that regular correspondence? It's not you, because you have your own line. It's not us.
Yes, I was also confused.
Right. So I think
because you have Director of Development Services report. So that's the staff report or correspondence.
Right.
So the only other thing I could think of is that it was just correspondence from that staff had given to you versus what you would like to relay, you know, an event or something like that. That's the only thing I could think of. But, well, I mean, you could do the same thing under commissioner's correspondence. So just to get rid of one light item.
No, I think if something comes into you that should come to us, you get a letter from, I don't know, wetlands. That would be correspondence.
Right.
And that's where that would fall in. And you would read it to us, or you would tell us. And so it should stay. Commissioner Boulay.
Thank you. What if you just added correspondence from staff? Would that simplify it?
No, because what if it's an outside body? It's from the council.
Yeah, but they would still have to go through staff to us, right?
Yeah.
So just to make it simple, I mean, I don't know if that's being redundant with the other one, but I just need to be simple language.
I don't mind removing it, but I think under Robert's rules, it probably should stay. Commissioner?
Yeah, looking at this, and I didn't know what it was when I looked at it. However, if staff gets all the correspondence that comes to the commission, then why do you need it? Because they could give you that correspondence under the staff reports.
They could.
And that's where it should be, I think, right at the moment anyway, unless I'm totally out of whack.
Well, my only concern is under Robert's rules, does that line have to stay there? And I don't mean that's a question for the town.
Why does that line have to stay there?
Because we have to follow Robert's rules.
Okay.
I'm not sure if we can get rid of it or not. We don't need it, obviously.
If you get rid of it in your bylaws, then you're rid of it.
Is there one of our viewers, members outside?
Yeah.
Ken, what do you think?
This is Ken Holinsky here. I had a couple of suggestions there. I would think we could label that maybe outside correspondence. It's kind of a real generic term, and that could mean anything. You know, anything of importance that we feel we need to discuss. I think we should leave the item there and maybe call it outside correspondence. If, you know, if anyone has a better nomenclature than that, I'd certainly be willing to discuss that. And so I think we should keep it, and I think we should keep it as outside correspondence. It's a broad subject, and we can, you know, it could mean from staff, it could mean from council, it could mean from other agencies, whatever it is.
I like that, Ken.
I like that, Ken.
Anybody else? Walter?
I'm going on history with the Board of Ed. We had correspondence on there too, and it was like that. It was other groups that would give us a letter or something to read.
Right.
Where you were saying to it would go through the planners, but she has her planner report, and there was a correspondence, just like the superintendent has his report and his correspondence.
Yes.
And back to executive session, why can't we make that at the end of the meeting, where then everybody can go, we can have executive session and end the meeting?
Well, because it may have something to do with something that's on the agenda.
But then we could always make a motion and move executive session up during the meeting.
Well, I'm trying to get it away from the regular meeting, so we don't pull away from here. Because the way it's right now, we're either walking out or clearing the room.
Okay.
Yeah. So I don't think that's fair. I mean, that's my opinion. And that's the way the council does it.
Well, like now, it's on there as needed.
Right.
So
if it was needed.
So if you don't have it on the agenda, you can't put it on the agenda, is what I'm saying.
Exactly. So that's
you could have it on there as needed and just leave it there. And if we need it, we move it around wherever. But if it's not on the agenda, you can't put it on the agenda.
Right. So what would happen was, like the council does, they'll notify Lori, the attorney, the town attorney, or if we ask for an executive session the next meeting.
Then we could have a special meeting.
It would be 6:30 or 6 or whatever the town attorney thinks. And that it will be its own agenda, its own posting, its own notice.
But I would say leaving it on the agenda in case we needed one during a meeting, we couldn't put it back on the agenda if it's not there.
Right.
So if we just leave it there as needed, we just don't do one. That's my suggestion.
Yeah. No, what's everybody else think? I just don't think it's proper to walk out of the room in the middle of the meeting.
You cannot put, after agenda set, you can't put it back on the agenda.
I hear Ken or John out there.
Yeah, Ken. This is Ken again. I also was chaired the Board of Education at one time. And I remember, from what I remember, we did it either before or after, depending on the circumstances. Okay? Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure exactly how we kept it on the agenda. Okay? So it seems to me it should be a flexible thing that we could put on there. You know, perhaps we just put it at the beginning of the agenda you know, executive session and say the executive session, we could move it to the end, or we could do it separately. Something like that. I'm not too sure of the logistics, but I know we did it. And Walter, maybe you could help me with this because you were chairing the board. But, you know, I thought we did some before and we did some after, depending on the circumstances.
We did, but we had if we needed, we had a special meeting with executive session.
Right.
But we had it always on the agenda because what I was told, if it's not on the agenda, you can't add it. So we had it at the end and we could always make a motion to move it. So even if you have it at the end, I don't know if you have it at the beginning, you can make a motion to bring it halfway through the meeting. You can't make a motion to go back. I don't know. So if we have it at the end, we can always move it up wherever, if needed. It's just there if needed.
Commissioner, that would be okay with me. I think that's a good suggestion.
Historically, we've had it on our agenda, but when we've had executive sessions, we generally have them at 6:30. Or 6 o'clock. We do it prior to the meeting so that we don't disrupt the flow, but it's always been on the agenda.
But it should, then if you're doing it that way, it shouldn't be on the agenda.
But there are times that we've had to stop the meeting and go into an executive session. It was a specific time that we had to do that. So leaving it on the agenda is good. But then we can have that special meeting if we have to, because it's an as needed. We're not in executive right. session every meeting.
Exactly.
The only time we go into an executive session when there's something the attorney feels that we need to have a conversation right. about, or we feel we need to have a conversation.
So with Commissioner DeGray, I say the same thing. If we had it 6:30, it would be a separate meeting.
Right, exactly.
Which would have a roll call. Executive session, come out of executive session, that meeting's over, come to this meeting.
Right.
But if it's on the agenda, it's there just in case we need it.
Next, Lori has a comment. Lori, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So if you have an executive session as a separate meeting, that's perfectly fine, and I think that's not a bad idea. It's still good to have the executive session as needed on the agenda, because when you get out of executive session, you always say no votes were taken, right. no decisions were made. But if a decision was made, you need to announce that, and right. that's where you would yep. announce it.
I think keeping it on the agenda is important. Because like Walter said, you can maybe move it around if you need to. Maybe it's at the end of the agenda, but I think it needs to stay on there.
Okay. Lawrence, did you have a comment?
Lori made the same comment I was going to have. You have to have it on the agenda, even mm-hmm. if you have the executive session first. Mm-hmm. Because if you have to take action on what you did in the executive session,
okay.
and you want to vote on it, you have to have something on the okay. agenda in order to be able to do that.
Yep. So, yep. Okay. So that works. We'll keep it there. But, you know, as chair, I think I would like to say to staff, if we have an executive session, you know that we're going to need one, you know, we'll have a 6:30 meeting. And then what you guys are saying, good point, we can come back out and use that line to say X, Y, and Z. But I just want to get away from walking out of the meeting here on item 4.
I totally understand that.
You know?
Absolutely.
I think it'll just keep the flow going. So as chair, I think I can coordinate with staff.
Mm-hmm.
And so
absolutely.
Everybody good with that one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Just so it, you know, you have people that are coming here, professionals and architects yeah. and, you know, the public, and they're here.
They want to stop the meeting.
Right, yeah. right. And that's, I just kind of felt that it wasn't right to do that. But I think we'd keep it there. And if we need an executive session, Lori will notify me, or vice versa, and we'll go from there. Any other discussions on these item changes? Go ahead.
Through the chair, to staff. Would you be able to do that with this new program, switch this stuff around? I'm just asking, because I know that there was some concern about switching stuff
yeah,
around.
Yeah, absolutely. But what happens is it goes into a specific format. We just have to change okay. the format. But would you prefer to have the executive session just shown at the very end? And as Walter alluded to, you
that would be,
change
that would
it.
Be
I think
my,
that's a great idea.
That's fine.
That would be my idea.
I would second that.
That's fine. But, you know, it'll be talking about an executive session that we had gone into prior to the meeting.
Right.
Everybody good with that?
Well, there's also the possibility, if we have a special meeting and there's something we need to vote on, we could add it to a line in the agenda saying we have to take a vote for, this is what we discussed. So
we don't have a lot of executive sessions.
Under new business, we could add a line saying, hey, we need to make a vote on this, what we talked about.
And I apologize to everybody. It's just a little house cleaning to get started for our next 2 years. We just want to take care of this stuff tonight. So I appreciate your patience. This is how the sausage is made, right? All right. Okay. So it's right here with the agenda where we're talking about the bylaws. So according to bylaws, I think we have to talk about it tonight, agree, and then vote on it next meeting. I think it takes two meetings.
We can make the modifications for your review for the next meeting, and unless you want to continue the discussion and have more time to review the bylaws themselves.
I think we have majority agreement, correct?
Yeah, I think so. I think everybody's, okay. There's a consensus of agreement.
Mr.
And then,
Chair.
And then we'll talk about more bylaw stuff. I just wanted to get this out there tonight, and then we can continue. We're not done with the bylaws yet. If there's any other comments or any other suggestions. Go ahead, Mr.
I just want to clarify. I'm in agreement, I think. So we're saying public participation, skip down to number 8, public participation, director report, correspondence, commissioner correspondence, and then continues.
Right. If you look at tonight, it would be right now, planning staff is 18 at the end. We want to move it to 10.
Yep.
So tonight, 10 is the bond release. So in order, everything that you see will move down from 10, it looks like now, unless we make any other changes.
Yep.
Right?
Okay.
Under bond releases?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yep. And then the next one is the correspondence.
Yeah, the numbering I know.
Well, yeah, because the numbers move.
That's right, exactly. Yeah. That's why I just want to. So public, director report,
commissioner's correspondence. Yeah.
Did we resolve the fact that we're going to call the correspondence other correspondence?
Yeah, I think that's a great idea.
Yeah, I like that idea.
I think it was outside.
That covers everything.
Outside.
Yeah, outside.
Sorry.
Thank you for that, Ken. That was a good idea. So tonight, we had a motion to change it for tonight, which we can do anytime. We can move things around on the agenda. So we got that for tonight. And we still are on bylaws. So the bylaws were sent out to you in your package. Did anybody have any questions? Did you want more time to review it? Do you want to table it? Because you didn't get time to review it. And I opened it up to the body. Yeah. I'll go start down here. Walter?
I'm okay with the changes you made and what I've perused so far. I have no problem with
it. Only 4 or 5 pages.
Yeah.
I looked through it pretty extensively, actually, and have no problem with anything, and approve the changes that we were talking about tonight. So.
Okay. You're good with it, Christian?
Yeah, I'm good with the changes we've talked about. And
anything else see that jumps out at you?
Nothing that jumps out.
Okay. Linda?
I'm good.
Vinny?
Also good with the changes
in the draft. Christian,
yep, I think it's all good for what we're doing. Yep.
Lawrence?
Yeah, everything's good. The changes are fine with me, and
okay.
So everything else looks okay.
Okay. So, Lori, I'm sorry. Oh, did they have their hand up? I can't.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Oh,
yep. I'm good. Right.
Did you
I'm
guys
good
have
too.
Anything else? I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's Ken. I'm good with all of it as well.
Okay, John.
That's all right.
I got to get a night to get my bugs out here. Sure. I'm sorry, John.
I'm good with everything as well, Mr.
Good.
Chair.
I'm glad you're happy with it, and everybody's. I just wanted to get this out of the way tonight. And so, Lori, would you prepare for next meeting what we talked about tonight, and then next meeting? I think there just needs to be a consensus vote on it, or another vote.
Yep,
probably
we'll make the modifications for the next meeting.
And then we could. It's been a few years since it's been looked at, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Perfect.
Very good. All right. So that's done. Next item is the appointments. We took care of that. So TIF, I have to appoint a member. So I am currently the designee. Now, I'm not sure if the chair should keep himself on there, but I would like to remain for now because I'm in the middle of something that's been in front of us for so long. And I'd like to see it through. And then I could always, and tell me if I'm wrong or anybody has got any other opinions, I could always bring it back up again and move somebody else into that. But there's, you know, an application that we've been really, you know, going, a lot of work has been done on it. And I feel if somebody else came into it now, it would be like, oh my God, what is this? So I'm more than happy to relinquish that for, you know, down the road if somebody wants it.
Commissioner, I would be okay with you continuing as to what your, the project that you're on now, and after that, maybe we revisit it.
Right. I'm glad. I think that would be great.
Yep.
Just so it keeps the continuity.
Absolutely.
And, you know, this TIF is very important.
Laurie, a question to you. Is he being chair, is he ex facto a member of all these committees anyway?
I don't believe so, but I can double check.
That's how it was on the Board of Ed. The chairman was a member of every committee.
Okay.
As an ex facto.
I don't think it's an issue.
I don't know. But again, leaving him on as now is also not
right.
An issue.
We can look into that. I mean, I just think that, you know, a lot of work has gone into this. Councillor Santinella and Councillor Pisner are the liaisons as well. And I think they still are. So the three of us are still there with everybody else.
Yeah, to me, continuity is everything.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Finish what you started and then we'll
revisit. We'll revisit it. How's that sound, guys, girls, ladies? Good? Okay.
Very good.
I'm good. Oh, sorry, guys. My first night, you had to be in TV land.
Just letting you know we're here, that's all.
Thank you. Okay, CROG, two members. Currently, it's Commissioner Petronella and myself, and so I will relinquish that for sure. John, are you still want to stay with CROG?
I guess I could stay on there. I think I missed one meeting out of four, I think it was. It's sometimes a little bit difficult, but I can hang in there.
Okay. So we'll leave. John will be there. Anybody else interested in being on CROG? And I'll have Lori give you a little overview of.
Now, what time are the meetings? That's
they're on computer. John, yeah. they're John. Would you explain the times?
Yeah, they're on. They come on. I think about seven o'clock it's typically a Thursday night I forget, is it the fourth Thursday? We're not on. We're not in session at that time. And it's, I think it's four times a year. There's four meetings a year. And they send you out email notifications and information of what the agendas are and so forth. The meetings will last anywhere between an hour, sometimes two. You know, they're pretty good, pretty informative. So, They're not too bad. They run pretty well, and generally they get a good full house of you know, about 20 plus people involved. And it's all done via Zoom.
Right,
John.
Could I?
Oh, sorry.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
New guy question. So, what does CROG do?
Okay.
Want to have Lori give you an overview of that? Yeah. Lori,
so
if you would,
CROG,
please.
So CROG is the Capital Region Council of Governments, and this is one of the things that they do is they have a regional planning commission, and so that is made up of planners from all the different municipalities. I can't remember the exact number of towns. It's around 30 towns in the Hartford CROG region. They do a myriad of other things, but in this case, they're just looking for somebody to be on that regional planning commission. I pulled off the schedule tonight, and it said that they typically are held on the third Thursday of every month at 7 p.m. via Zoom, unless noted otherwise. However, they only held four meetings last year, so, and they are virtual, so you don't have to like drive into Hartford. So they're pretty interesting, actually.
Are you interested, Walter? Or we'll go around the table? Or?
If I'll be the last one, if anyone else doesn't want it, I'll take it.
I'll start down with Mr. Mule.
I've already done it. Thank you very much. I was on it for a long time. And there are some really interesting things for the new people to get your feet wet. There's stuff on transportation, the DOT. There's so many things that you can learn through it. So.
Well, thank you. One thing that just came to my mind, and no disrespect, can alternates take those positions?
Yeah.
Okay. Commissioner D'Antonio.
I'd be happy to, actually. Yeah, this sounds like a good opportunity. Okay. And I presume, you know, if anything comes up, maybe, you know, share, you know, any...
Well, you report back to us.
Exactly, yeah. Share exactly with everybody here what comes out of those meetings. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it sounds like a great opportunity. I'd be happy to.
So Walter and Christian and...
Unless Mr. Petronella doesn't want it anymore.
Well, John's on it. Two people. Well, John, you're going to stay on it? You said he's staying.
Yeah, that's correct. I'll stay on
it. So I'm okay with Chris taking it. He's been on longer than I, so.
Yeah, okay. Maybe you could have got your traffic light.
That's what I was thinking.
I know you were thinking
but
that.
But I'm not pushing
I can read
it.
Your mind.
I got other methods to get that. So.
Commissioner D'Antonio, congratulations. Thank you. Report back and anything that we need to know.
Sounds great. Yeah.
Thank you for stepping up and taking that. Appreciate
it. Yeah. You're welcome. Glad to help out.
All righty.
Okay, so...
My mic. The minutes of the preceding meeting, December 21st, 2023. Has everybody had an opportunity to review the minutes? Is there any comments, corrections, amendments? Of course, the new guys, you won't be voting on this. Everybody else, did you have a chance to look? Linda usually has a couple of things, so.
Hey, I'm just making a motion.
You're very thorough. I like that.
I'm just like motion.
I like that because you read every word.
I do. I read all of my packets.
That's why I like that.
So I'm just making a motion to approve the minutes.
Okay. Is there a second on a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Second? Second by Commissioner Garrillo. All in favor, show of hands.
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Passed.
On a record.
Passed.
We have
a record.
Yeah.
So 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3.
3 abstentions.
And 2 on TV. They said yes.
Abstained.
No, they said yes.
Yeah, right. 3 abstentions. The rest said yes. Yeah, we said yes.
Now, I think why we're here at this point for the new people, if you do miss a meeting, you can watch the video, review the minutes, and then have a comment at the next meeting if you didn't attend. But you need to watch the video and read the minutes, then you're welcome to comment. Okay? Next item on is number 6, town attorney report. Town attorney is not here. I don't see Mr. Tyler. So we have no report. Oh, we do. We have a written report from the assistant town attorney.
Right. Mr. Chair, if you don't mind, this comes in on paper.
Yep.
Rather than having the town attorney actually attend.
Right. So this is going to be from Mr. Serrato, I believe. Yeah. So review it, and if there's any questions. It looks like these have been the ones that have been ongoing for several months. I do know that one of, so outside counsel has taken 6 and 7, Shipman and Goodwin. So I don't know how that works, whether we get reports via our town attorney when needed or Shipman and Goodwin comes in. I'm not sure how that's going to work.
I think it will
logistical.
Be. It will be from our attorneys.
Okay. So that moved out, so you guys know it's been on the burner for, I think, 2 or 3 years now. So is everybody good with the review? All in favor? Show of hands.
Yep.
Okay, town attorney's report is done. Thank you, Mr. Serrato. I think he did it. Next item on the agenda, executive session. We beat that up already, I think, right? Okay. Is Rick here tonight for next item number 8?
He is not.
Okay. Does he have any correspondence for us?
There was no report for this meeting, but we could get one soon.
Okay. Maybe he's getting a little bit of a break. Now is time for public communications. And public communications in this format is what we do, is we invite the public up to speak on anything about planning and zoning, about development you may see, any questions you have about the operation of the planning department. You can come up and speak and ask any questions. You just can't ask about anything on the agenda that's going on now. So, but if there is a public hearing later in the meeting, you are welcome to come up and speak about that. So at this point, if there's anybody that would like to come up and address the committee, the commission, or staff, you're welcome to. I don't see anybody coming up, so we'll move on to the next item. So here's where I think we got the changes coming in, right? From 10. What?
I don't think.
Point of order?
Can, mm-hmm. Point of order to staff. Since we haven't adopted the changes yet.
What?
We didn't vote on that and because we were.
I opened with a motion.
Right.
To move for tonight.
Okay, you're right. I apologize.
To get it.
That's why.
To get it in.
Because we had that whole conversation.
Right. So the first thing.
I don't think it was.
Well, I'm trying.
Okay.
The first thing I did was ask for a motion to get it next to the.
Yeah.
Where we are.
All right.
Yep. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Well, yeah, you made the motion. No one ever seconded it. We didn't vote on it.
We didn't vote
that's
on
right.
it.
We were assuming it was for future meetings,
right.
Not for today's meeting.
No, I made the motion for tonight to move.
Okay. Well, I didn't hear the word tonight. I'm sorry.
I did not either. I was
nobody did.
I don't think any. We didn't vote on it. That's why.
Oh, I thought we did. We didn't vote on it?
No, we didn't.
We voted on the changes.
And we got tracked.
Okay.
Yeah, because
okay.
Then we went into the
so
bylaws.
Then,
so
for. So we did vote tonight on the bylaws.
So you want to suspend the rules and change the order of the
yeah, I
order
asked for a motion when we started, yeah. So we can only so we can practice the new way of doing it tonight,
okay,
basically.
Well,
okay.
So it's up
so
to you guys.
So let's do it now.
Yeah, that's
you
right.
Make the motion. You suspend the rules.
And we'll suspend the regular agenda. We're going to move item 18 to item 10, item 16 to 11, and item 17 to 12. Do I have a
second?
Seconded by Commissioner DeGray.
What's the last one?
17 to 12.
17 to
12. 18 to 10. We did it. Well, okay, we're ready. Vote, please, by hand. All in favor? It was voted seconded. Okay. Guys, thank you very much out there in TV land. So we are going to hear from Lori. At this point, staff.
I don't have a whole lot.
I'm sorry. First of all, congratulations, new members and reappointed. Glad to see a full board here. That's very good. It's always a wonderful thing to see a full board. One announcement is Rebecca, our recording secretary, has given her notice only because that she is. She has her son has a sports team playing on Thursday nights. So we're probably going to switch our recording secretaries and she'll take the other Sandra, Inland Wetlands Conservation and Ag Commission, and then Sandy will take this planning and zoning. So so we'll probably have a switch over, but right now we don't have any recording secretary, but luckily it's being filmed. So just a reminder for, especially for the new commissioners, the Public Act 2129 requires that every year the commissioners have 4 hours of training. Right now it's all virtual. As the year progresses, they'll probably have more like in-person training. So we can work together on that. And I was just going to remind people, you know, New Year, kind of some new members, and you probably all know about this, but no ex parte communication. If there's an application pending, you should not be discussing it outside of a meeting with your family, friends, strangers, or anybody else. You should be trying to keep everything to yourself and your own. If you have questions, please contact staff. We could help you decipher whatever it is you might have an issue with. And just a reminder, just try to review them on the basis of the regulations and whether they're compliant or not. And try not to reveal your personal feelings during the meetings, because that's really, it could get everybody in trouble doing that. So it was just a quick little reminder on that. I apologize for not having staff here tonight. It was such a short agenda. We've got a longer agenda coming. You're going to see a lot of our staff, Matt Davis, Georgie Driver, and Rick Rischelli. Those are our two assistant planners and our zoning enforcement officer. And we may have all of us here at the next meeting. So I apologize that they all live kind of far away. So, well, with the exception of Rick, but and they had some issues going on this evening. So I do apologize for that. They're probably watching, so.
Lori,
That's about it.
Okay, so I have a question on the courses or the mandatory classes. We discussed this. Mm-hmm. I think we discussed it offline about them notifying you of people that attended. Were you able to?
I've not been getting those.
And so, you were going to look into that.
I know. You and I will have to talk. I truly believe that you took your courses, so I'm not really worried. I think everybody that has been on this commission has met their requirements.
Mm-hmm.
New people, we'll have to chat.
Right. But we just need, I would like to find out an answer from them to see if they're going to send the record to the town. I think, you know, and they did say that when I was on with them, because I asked, you can ask questions to the proctor why the course is going on, and I typed the message to them, and they said, yes, they do. So, I mean, if it's important, you know, enough for to make members require members, it's important enough to respond back to the community that they indeed have taken it, and it goes in the file.
I completely agree.
Thank you. So
but
we can,
I will
we'll work on it together. If you need me to come up someday, let me know, and we'll get that straightened out. And Lori, was that all you had?
That is all I have for you this evening.
So we're going to move public communications. We did.
So 16 correspondence. To 11.
Commissioner's correspondence. So what I think I'll do, and I'm not going to do this normally. I'm going to have other people go first. But I'm going to start tonight, if you guys don't mind, with some correspondence. And I think, you know, I have it down as what I would like to see as our collective goals for the next 2 years. And just some things to think about. And I think they're rather important. The first thing I got is I definitely want to tackle amending the zoning regulations and the zoning maps. Lori, question to you. Do we still have Don Poland on with us under contract? I know there was an RFQ, an RFP went out to him for the study. And is he still, there was two pieces, wasn't there?
So yes, we do still have him under contract. You know, it's been a while since we've corresponded because there kind of was like put a hold on some of, you know, they didn't want to do a lot of updates when they knew that they were getting a new commission, as you well know. So we've done about 3/4 of the zoning regulations already, and he's on board to help us for the rest. But I kind of wanted to figure out who the new chairman was, and then we could maybe talk, you know, privately just to figure out, you know, roadmap for
right,
the future.
So nothing, you've got suggestions. You haven't changed anything.
Of
You've
course, yeah.
Right. You no, have suggestions. No. Mm-hmm. But we need to have meetings. I'm thinking it's going to require a little bit of time to have a meeting other than this meeting. Because it's just, again, it's too much on the agenda. It's not fair to the public. It's not fair to the professionals that are here. But it's something I think that has been talked about for a long time. It has to get done. It has to get done.
I totally agree.
I mean,
thank you.
Yeah. We're going to make everything that's non-conforming conforming, and we're going to look at everything in today's world and straighten things out, and hopefully you know, when we have applicants come forward, things will be a little easier on them. So that's one of the items I had. The other item I have, well, I got several, so I'm not going to end here quickly, and I want anybody to chime in here too. I want to pursue the traffic study. I am just so tired of study after consultant, whether we pay for it or the state pays for it. We get all these fancy, lovely, touchy, nice, feely things, and they go up in the attic. I've had it with that. this study was done. We entertained them. We had meetings. We had public hearings. The people came to look at it. So I want to pursue that and find out where it is. Lori, if you would, can you please email the study to our state delegation? Rep Hall, Arnone, and Kissel, because I am going to follow up with them as well and reach out to them, even if we have to have them come here. But this business of, you know, we're going to have all these things done, and I've been hearing it for 40 years, and everybody gets all excited and nothing happens.
Chairman, is that in an effort to consolidate or finalize all that?
Well, it was a mall. The traffic study was done for the mall area, which are things are happening. You know, some things are going on, and we need to get that done. And I did ask who's going to pay for it, and where's the money coming from? And then somebody from Hartford chimed in and said, oh, no, we're going to fund this one. This is going to happen. So, Lori, if you would please email the state delegation. Mm-hmm. They're going into session soon. I know it's a short session this year, but I want to get answers on that.
So, okay.
Could you do that for me, please? Mm-hmm. Okay. We updated. So, the amendment to the agenda. Update of the wetland maps. I want to make our wetlands usable for public pleasure and recreation. We have wetlands in this town, and I don't believe the maps have been changed since the 60s. I could be wrong. I'm not sure. I have heard that. We're not the Redwood Forest. This isn't national parks and where we're protecting species and certain things like that. I think we just have soils. We may have some turtles and frogs, but it's looked at like, oh my God. I think we need to look at the wetlands. And again, I said at last meeting, perfect example is the Noble gas station. Amazing what they did back there. There was a piece of land that nobody could build on for as long as I can remember. And now they have a nice usable wetland back there where you can take a walk and you can sit. They got the pond. And I think you're gonna have to wait the spring to really appreciate it. But we have an industrial park that, oh my God, it's wet. We gotta look at this. You talk about animals, the deer live in there. You want to be a deer and live in there? Where are you going to go? You're going to get whacked on freshwater. You're going to go on a highway. You're going to get killed, or you're going to get killed on South Road. So we would relocate the deer if we have to. It's not a safe place for them. I wouldn't want to be a deer living in an industrial park. Your life expectancy is very short. So the wetlands, we need to do that. Me, and I, this is the way I think of things, I approach all the applications when they come in, and my mindset is, what do we have to do to approve this? Not what are we going to do to turn it down. If it doesn't make it, it doesn't make it. But you've got to focus on, what do we do to approve this? Balance the development. We can't place the tax burden on the residents, all the residents. We have to make sure that we're doing a balance. Because if we don't, people aren't going to be able to afford to live in this town. We need to be proactive with that. And that's something, I think should be done. Don't try to place the burden on all the taxpayers and, entertain business. We need to be business friendly and tell people and let people know that Enfield's open for business. And, we're here for you, and we're going to treat everybody respectfully and entertain their applications. Alternate members I spoke about already. One of the things, talking about the courses that are required, affordable housing. Over the last few years, we beat affordable housing to death. Enfield is above the state standards, above the state requirements. Enfield meets them. From what I understand, Lori, you may know better than me, that not even half of the 169 towns in the Connecticut have met the requirements of affordable housing. I don't know the number, but it's not that
high. I don't know the number.
But we have, and we've been there for a long time. So what I think we need to do is build houses that are more affordable. And that gets back to our regulations, our setbacks, our lot sizes. I don't think that people are into the big 3,000 square foot houses on the big lots anymore. I think that's something of the past. We need to start looking at that, and that, you know, that goes, you know, back to our zoning and our maps and our whole review of everything. You know, a developer is going to come in, and if he could build 75 houses instead of 25 houses, they'll come, and they'll do it, and the guy can make some money. But the way it is now, our zoning is crazy, all over the place. I mean, we got stuff that's R30, 80, R88. Who's going to build on R88? It's not going to happen. You know, the return just isn't there. So we need to start looking at, you know, smaller, affordable homes on smaller lots. You know, because, and if we do fall below the affordable housing, we'll take care of it. But, you know, a lot of people have came in here and, you know, talking about, oh, affordable housing, but we're there. I mean, you know, we meet what we need to meet. And, you know, we get a lot of pushback on that. And so I think we, you know, build housing that's affordable. That people can, you know, on middle income or whatever, or even below middle income, can buy the house. So that's, again, goes back to the regulations. So that was my opening commissioner correspondence. Again, I'm not going to be first going forward. I'm going to let other people go. So anybody would like to speak on some of the things I talked about, some of the things you have on your mind that you'd like to see? Tonight's our first meeting with a new body here. So those are some of the things I would like us to accomplish. Now, I'm not saying me, I mean us. We should, you know, work together, and Lori will get us the information on Mr. Poland and I mean how much use we have left of him, and we'll go from there. So I open it up to everybody. Walter?
One word. Ditto.
Thank you.
Absolutely, I agree. I think, you know, the mall and the maps that we talked about, that you talked about, are important to the town, even for not just now, but going forward.
Thank you.
I do agree with you, Mr. Chairman. I'll just add on to the point about the traffic study. I know there's kind of a mix in terms of responsibilities. There's definitely things that we can do going forward, especially as we go to update the regulations. So that's a big piece, is recognizing, you know, the study was about, you know, what can certain types of development do. So as part of our regulation review, we need to say, okay, this is what the study mm-hmm. told us. Is that allowed, and should we allow that? Mm-hmm. So there are definitely things we can do in the meanwhile as we're waiting for the state to, you know, work on Route 220 itself.
Yeah. I need them to spend some money up here. That's where I'm going. And everybody yeah. down on Hartford, down there, they don't forget about Little Enfield up here.
Right.
Now, we got to get some of the money coming back up here.
Right.
We're
here
not so little.
Dog and pony show, and then nothing happens.
They need to realize we're not so little.
Right. And I think we have to show them we're serious. We're serious. We've made the zoning changes that will facilitate the development we want to see.
Exactly.
So that's important. If you don't mind, Mr. Chair, I just had two more small things that, sure. I, that had come up. Just small concerns that I've seen and heard. One was just, I don't want to beat this dead horse, but we've all kind of brought up concerns with the mall property before.
Mm-hmm.
We've only had one snowstorm this year. They did a very poor job
at
clearance.
It.
That's really something we need to look out for. Their property is used as a actual throughway, as well as Phoenix Road. Which I think is a public road.
You remember it took me 2 years to get them to put the lights on.
The lights were a big problem. So it's just something, you know, we have to keep an eye out. Zoning enforcement needs to keep an eye out for. Again, we have that's a major, that's our town's only transit stop.
Mm-hmm.
It's very important for them to properly maintain their property, even if nobody's shopping at the mall, on that side of the mall. The other thing was another concern I've heard, which was about the Aldi, Petco, Michael's Plaza. I know, you know, we are concerned with traffic and safety, and I've heard concerns about going into the plaza from the westernmost entrance closest to I-91.
Okay.
So it's a four-way intersection. Yep. Inside the plaza. The entrance does not have a stop sign, but there's a lot of confusion with that intersection because
inside the plaza.
Inside the plaza.
I don't know how much jurisdiction we have, but
right, exactly. I'm not sure that we can mandate it, but I think it may be something to consider.
We can ask them nicely.
We can ask them nicely, even just signage. Mm-hmm. You know, traffic. You know, incoming traffic does not stop at the three stop signs.
I think the work we've done with that particular mall, they seem pretty responsive.
Right.
I think we could, you know,
and if it's just
maybe
about signage, I don't see why they would.
Right. I think they were good. I think that's a good run mall.
Yeah.
Right. You know? Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm sure you guys all have experience there. I've definitely seen.
No, it is.
It was brought to my attention, and sure I think about it. I'm like, yeah, that place is a nightmare sometimes.
Yeah.
And yeah, so I just want to throw it out there. Through the chair, perhaps to staff, if we can,
perhaps we can get Rick to go see him and talk to him. Or
see if there's.
I mean, there's not much we can do on private property. You know, there, Laurie, if you would. And
well, my guess is that there were probably stop signs required in their original plan, so we could go out and look at that.
Right.
And
yeah.
Also talk to traffic.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Going into that plaza and making the U into Ruby, what's the restaurant there, is an absolute nightmare. So I hear you.
No, it's important, and public safety is always important. So thank you for bringing that up.
A lot of close calls.
Yeah, and I know there's a big line of traffic always in front of that.
It's slow speed, which is good, but close calls don't get counted, but there's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Commissioner DeGray, if you want.
I think some of your concerns will be taken care of when we do the regulations, but what I would like to see is a schedule of workshops with these regulations. You're two-thirds done, but we still have work to do, and people are asking when the workshops will be for our regulations, so the sooner we can get a schedule.
You mean workshops or public hearings?
Workshops.
Well, that's what I was saying. I want to have meetings. Right. Other than here. Is that what you mean?
Those are workshops.
Right. So, but it'll be a posted
but
meeting.
But they're open to the public as well, so that we can get input
right
there, and then we have our public hearings. But I'd like to see that
sooner
than later.
My thought is we do it by section, and reinvent the horse, but we have something in place in town for 100 years, the fire districts. Let's take it fire district at a time. And focus on, and then we'll get to do the whole town. And building and taxation has the fire districts are in that too.
I don't think we can do it that way, but I think we can take section by section that we have currently.
Yep.
And if Don is two-thirds done with it, we could start workshops. But
you know, because the zoning in Thompsonville is very different than the zoning in Hazleville.
That one was
you know,
done.
Enfield District is very different than, you know.
Thompsonville was done 2 years, no, 19.
But it needs to be looked at.
A little bit, yeah. There's a little tweaking on that.
But I mean, we don't have to use, I'm just saying, to make it easier and start looking at the whole town, just look at chunks at a time.
We look at our zoning regulations chapter by chapter.
Okay.
Yeah,
we need to get on that.
Workshops, yes.
Absolutely, I agree. Commissioner Grillo.
Mr. Chair, I just want to say I agree with all your goals, and I look forward to helping you accomplish them. That's all.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that, Denny. Mr. Mulay.
Yes, sir. I would have to agree. It sounds like a good plan and gives us some good work to do.
I think
it's a great plan.
Thank you.
Lynch. Yeah, I think the plan you want to put together is very needed. When you look through the regulations and you look at all the various things we have that we certainly could simplify and make it more meaningful to everybody rather than have everybody and their brother living in non-conforming places or businesses are all non-conforming. That just doesn't make a lot of sense to me.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. John, what do you think?
Yeah, Mr. Chair, I take no exception to your goals. I approve.
Ken, any input or what do you think on the goals?
I agree. I think they're all good goals. There, many of them we've been trying to do for a while. So I think it's a good idea to put a priority on.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
I appreciate all of you being on board with that. I know, like I said, it's going to require us to do a little extra work, but I mean, it'll help us and all the commissions going forward. It'll help the applicants. They won't have to go through so many hoops. It'll be cut and dry. They'll know what they can do and what they can't do. And I think that's important because, again, we want to make sure we always emphasize we're business friendly and we're open for business. Okay, so that was Commissioner's correspondence. So now we were going to be able to move enforcement. So bond releases. Any bond releases? No bond releases. There was no continued public hearings. There's no new public hearings.
Yes, sir. Oh,
what's coming up? Oh, yeah. No. Under new business. Okay. Old business?
No. You have no old business, but we get a public hearing.
Right. But the public hearing, then it should be up underneath 11.
It was.
In the wrong spot.
It's in the wrong
spot.
Here
we go again. Look at
it. So it's new.
Attorney Landolino's ready to get up. sorry for the delay, Carl.
Business.
But, so it should be up under. That should be under new business.
Does John have the
public? John, so we're down. Is there any? We're going to do that now. We're not going to use old business or new business yet. We're going to go right to the public hearing. John, if you would, Mr. Chair, can you read the notice? Mr. Secretary.
At the Enfield Planning and Zoning Commission will hold a public hearing at their regular meeting on Thursday, January 11th at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers at 820 Enfield Street, Enfield, Connecticut, concerning the following. Public hearing number 3085, 98-106 Pearl Street, application for special use permit to sell alcohol under a Class 5 license, a Gray's Athletic Association, Inc. applicant, Carl Landolino, representative, map 24, lot 158, TD2 zone.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Welcome, applicants, name and address and title for the record, please.
Yes, good evening, Mr. Chair, members of the commission. My name is Carl Landolino. I'm an attorney at the firm of Fahey and Landolina in Windsor Locks. Seated to my right is Steve Grissett, who is the vice president of Gray's Athletic Association, Inc. Sadly, since over the holidays, the association lost its president. He passed away, I believe, the day after Christmas.
Yeah.
Anyway, just to move forward, so I'm guessing I don't have to tell you who Gray's is. Most of you have lived here a lifetime. The association goes back almost 100 years, and their first home in Thompsonville was actually on this property or in the...
It was in the back of the property.
Back behind the property we're talking about now. Then at some point they moved over to Main Street in their building, which housed them for decades. As you know, there was a fire there a couple of years ago, I guess, destroyed the building. Gray's decided that they would not rebuild in that other location and has been looking for a home, a new home, I've been working with them for almost a year. This is our second or third pass, not in front of you, but, you know, trying to get things organized. One of the, I don't want to call it an impediment, it wasn't such that, but one of the hurdles we had to jump through is that when you redid the TD zones, you eliminated the club alcohol permit as a permitted use in all of the TD zones. The only alcohol related uses that are permitted are restaurants, and I think there's one other. But club permits are no longer permitted in the TD zone. So we had to go to the Zoning Board of Appeals to get a use variance, and we actually did it on another piece of property because we were close to a lease agreement with them. That did not work out, so we abandoned that use variance for a piece of property nearby in the area. And we went back to Zoning Board of Appeals and said, first one didn't work out. We abandoned that use variance. We're not going to record it. It's not effective. But we think we've got a home here at this location. And they granted us a second use variance for this specific location. The appeal period for that variance has run. So assuming we get approval from this board to operate in that location, that variance will go on to land records, become effective, and then we'll record this special use permit that hopefully you're going to grant us this evening. And Gray's will be able to at least start work in the interior of that building to move into it and get their club restarted in this location. So they had the opportunity, I suppose, to go outside of the Thompsonville area. They didn't want to. The members have been associated with the Thompsonville area for over 100 years. They want to stay in Thompsonville. And I think it's a great location for them, and that's where they want their home to be. They don't want to be in Hazardville or North Thompsonville or, you know, Enfield proper. Their home is Thompsonville, and that's where they want to stay. So we've got a use variance, which means that notwithstanding the fact that this use is not permitted in this zone, we've got a variance, so that issue would be off the table. We are planning to move into this building at 98106. You're probably all familiar with it. If you drive by, it's sort of the blue building on the west side of Pearl Street. There's a convenience store in half the building or half the first floor, and Gray's intends to occupy the southern half of the first floor. It's got a stone facade. Then just directly to the south is a parking lot, which does not belong to this building. It belongs to the other building adjacent, which is, this used to house Enfield Pizza, but they're next door now, and then we got a parking lot in between. So that's the idea, is to move their operation, their club, into that location. And as pointed out, I think staff did a fantastic job of giving you the information I think you need, better than I would have done. But, you know, simply stated, they need a special permit so they can go to Department of Consumer Protection, ask for a Class 5 club permit only. You can't change from one permit to the other. That's all we're asking for. So it couldn't, if I don't know, 100 years from now, they decide to move again. If there was a restaurant in there, that would not give that restaurant the right to have a liquor permit. They'd have to come in front of you to do that under the regulations, and I don't see those parts of the regulations changing dramatically. But this would be limited to a Class 5 club permit. You know, when I was in doing this in front of the ZBA, one of the questions astutely asked by one of the members is, how's the club business? I know where I grew up, we had Windsor Locks is a small town. We had 6 or 7 clubs. We had 2 American Legions in Windsor Locks. We had the KSC. We had the Italian. We had 2 Italian clubs, you know, because a lot of us guys ended our names in vowels. But you look around in your neighborhoods, it's probably the same thing. Those places are disappearing, you know. I know my wife grew up on Betty Road off of Washington. The KSC is still even operating
yep.
there?
Yeah.
But that's probably one of the last in town.
Mont Carmel's still going.
Mont Carmel. Absolutely. Yeah, but there's very few, you know.
Not as a bar.
I guess the younger people, you know, do different things with their time than participate in the Rotary Club or the KSC or all those fraternal clubs that used to be very popular at one time. And what I see is, frankly, a lot of those clubs are being taken over by churches. You know, that's where the churches, the first thing the independent churches are coming in, which is fine, but they're no longer clubs. So the likelihood of like 10 clubs moving into Enfield and wanting this place in the future is very limited. And the Grays has been around for a while, and they're going to remain in town as a fixture for a very long time. So we need a couple of waivers from you. They're cited in staff report. I think there's 3. Most necessary is parking waivers. Downtown Thompsonville is what it is. You know, we're fortunate in that there is a right across South Street or South, yeah, it's South Street. South Road is the other one. Yeah. You have two Souths in town. It is a public parking area, so we're fortunate to have use of that. There are only three spots on the site that were that are going to be dedicated to the club. There's some, obviously, street parking. Street parking is allowed on Pearl Street. It's, you know, well, you spent your entire career on Pearl Street. So, you know, that's just the way it is on Pearl Street. We're also asking for a waiver for any site plan requirements, which is allowed under your regulations. We're not making any changes outside. It is what it is. There's really no room to do anything. You know, I suppose they could re-site the building, but everything's going to be interior. So we're going to need a building permit and engineering to look at it. And, you know, assuming we get your approval, those will be the next steps. But right now, they need your permission to apply for a liquor license. So that's why we're here, so we can do that. So that's all really I have. I'd be glad to answer any questions. Probably everyone in this room behind me is a member of Gray's. And so if there's something I don't know, they'll know. And again, I thank staff for its thorough report. And I guess I'll just drop off at this point. Okay, that's probably the least amount of talking I've done in front of this board in many years.
Thank you, Attorney Landolina, for that presentation. I really appreciate it. And questions from the commissioners. We'll start. Go ahead, Mr. Grill.
Thank you. There was only one thing. This is fine. The parking, look, it's Thompsonville. The parking's never, it's going to be what it is. We can't. Right. I don't have a problem with the parking. The only concern I really have, and I'm sure we can solve this, it's not a big deal, is the, I know the building.
Yeah, the apartments upstairs.
I know
upstairs.
The apartments up above it. They're not, them houses, Carl, that house, we owned Royal Pizza, by the way, that was down.
Okay.
At yep. the bottom of that.
Yeah.
So I know that building very well, actually. I was in it for 3 years.
Right.
I'm just worried about the sound for the second floor. That's my concern. You know, there are residents. They do still live there. They have their back entrance up there and so forth.
Yeah, great
how
question.
How do we resolve that?
This is so, first of all, there are two types of liquor permits here in town. And I don't mean the classes. You have five classes, which is not unusual. But there's only two types. One with live entertainment and one with no entertainment. We're not asking for any entertainment. There's a jukebox in here. That's it for entertainment, other than whatever entertainment these guys provide to each other. Okay. And I'm not going there, because, you know. But so that's one thing. So we're not going to, you know. So they're in control of at least the noise in the jukebox. The other thing is, because we're going to be a commercial use, and we're doing work inside, we have to meet the current building codes. So there's going to be fire-rated ceilings put in. Right now, I think it's drop tiles, yeah, you know. That's nothing. So that's all got to come down, and we have to do a fire-rated ceiling that will protect the upstairs neighbors from some of the noise. Now, are they not going to hear anything at all? No, I can't guarantee that. But the other issue is these guys don't operate till 2 o'clock in the morning. Okay, like other liquor establishments. They close at 10, and we don't have a problem if you make that a condition of approval that we close at 10, right?
We will shut the jukebox off at 10. Very rarely okay. are we open.
Yeah, it's so.
Very rarely.
So I don't know if those things alleviate your concerns. I mean, I haven't talked to anybody upstairs. I know that Steve or some of the group has. But, you know, you're right, Vinny. They may not be tenants next year. It might be somebody else, you know. So if you have any suggestions.
Because you know what happens. They're going to get the calls. Then the calls go from there then to our police department.
Right.
And they're out there all the time because of the. That's all I'm trying to avoid, because I know they could keep it. If they do the ceiling right, the way it's supposed to be done, they can keep that noise down.
Mm-hmm.
There's ways to do it. I don't have the time to tell you, but good contractors will tell you how it's done right. They can put the sound deafeners in the ceiling. It's not going to cost you a whole new building. There's not much space you have there. But I really do think the noise will be a problem later, especially if you tell us now, well, we're not usually there till 10, but that means we all know a good night. it winds up. So I would maybe think about if you did approve it, definitely put a time limit on this. The time, I don't know. I would think the rest of the board, but do you,
can I have a minute?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
So I would offer to you this, Mr. Commissioner Grillo, and to the members of the commission. If you wanted to add a condition, we don't have any noise studies to show you or, you know, an acoustical engineer to talk about it, but we would agree to a condition that said we would use our best efforts to put noise reduction a ceiling in that would not only be fire rated but alleviate some of the concerns about noise. That's the best I can offer you tonight. Yeah. Soundproof or noise reduction. Yeah.
All set, Mr. Commissioner
yes,
Grillo?
Ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'll move down. Do you have any questions?
Good evening. In that building right now, there's the grocery store next to South Street. And is the club going to be on the other end?
Yes, the south end of that, on the first floor.
On the south end of the...
Yeah. About 1,300 or 1,400 square feet there.
I didn't see that, but yeah. You got my concern. Some of the parking is my concern because it's going to be very easy just to park right along Pearl Street or right along Pearl Street. And I'm wondering, and it's no parking on the other side. I'm wondering is I haven't been down there at night in years, so. I'll be perfectly honest with that. I don't know how much parking is there on the street anyway. If people upstairs or people that are running the places, if they park on the street, especially on that end of the building, because the parking lot on that end of the building is for the pizza place, for the other building, so, or if everybody parks in the public parking, on South Street, Pearl and South. But you only have three parking places that the building has. And I believe it talks about having 20 spaces would be required. Mm-hmm. 15 to 20 spaces would be required. How many empty spaces are there at night on South Street? Or... then you're talking about maybe using some of the parking on New King Street. And if you take a look at that, a lot of those streets have been changed over the years to one way, so you haven't got a lot of parking space on the side of the streets. All I'm saying is I'm concerned a little bit about the parking, and I don't know whether there's a way that you can relieve some of my concerns. I'm not concerned about the use, mm-hmm. all that stuff. I'm concerned about the parking, and I don't know. You had a lot more parking down on Main Street, where you were on Main Street. Nobody's down there. And if you had to, you'd probably park in the apartment parking lot. But
well, to be honest with
and
you.
I'm sure you would never tell me that, but I'm sure you probably did. Okay.
Well, so I can tell you firsthand knowledge that some of the places that they used to park on Main Street have now changed ownership, the two vacant lots across from the old First National Bank. Yep. And the owners of those lots were not happy with the Grays Club parking in their lots. But notwithstanding that, this comes down to the question of parking. I would agree. If we were generally open to the public, I think it would be more of an issue. One of the things I can offer you is that these are members only. So they all know where they can park. We're, as soon as this place opens, they're going to know where they're allowed to park and where they're not. You know, they know that they can't park in the Enfield Pizza parking lot. That's off limits. I understand from Lori's report there's room for four cars out front of the building, another three in the back. It's going to be on-street parking or in that parking lot on South Street. So, and wherever parking, I guess, would be available. I don't know. Again, I'm these gentlemen would know better than I do. I don't know. On a typical night, how many people are...
Most of our members down there are walkers. That's why we want to stay downtown, because they all walk. And they all live around there. Basically, the most cars we have out front of the club at any given night, it's probably about 8 to 9, maybe 10. And there's always, at least you drive by the parking spot, the commuter parking right next door. There's always 10 spots open during the day, and nobody's really out at night. We don't go out at night. We're all workers. We go home for dinner, and we go home to our wives and family.
Okay. Thank you.
We don't have that many vehicles, really, at any given time.
Thank you. Come down this end. Any questions from the commission members on this side? Walter?
Your old building, you had tenants upstairs or no?
No.
Basketball. Shooting range.
There was a shooting range, okay.
A long time ago, though.
I rode my bike by that building back in the 70s because my father had the business in the Cascade building, and I rode there every day almost by there, so.
I would say a big fan of these type of clubs. I grew up in a small town where we had a couple of these clubs. That'd be a very... huge fan of keeping that tradition alive. But I do agree with Commissioner Guerrillo about the noise. For me, I'd like to see something in stone as to what is the plan for noise.
Walter?
I have one more comment.
Sure, go ahead.
This was public hearing, so there was given out notices to the tenants that this hearing was here, right?
There's a sign out front.
Sign out front. But was any letters to the tenants or no?
No,
that's not required
under your regulations.
Okay. So they still saw the sign when they were going into their building, so.
Assumably so.
And
yeah.
I don't see anybody here, so.
Properly posted is what they call it. They certify that they put the sign up. He has to present.
It's been up actually for months because we left the same sign from ZBA out there as well.
Just pointing out that.
No one's here. Right.
Commissioner DeGray.
Two things. One, you said there's three spaces in the back for parking for the club.
Yeah.
Where are the tenants parking? Are they parking back
the
there?
Back too.
Okay, because I know it's small back there because I lived in the house right behind it. That's right. Why I'm really familiar with this area. Yeah. So, and then through the chair to staff, they've got a variance for this particular property for a club, so that means that's there, it's there for the property and not just for the club. So another club, if they were to leave in 100 years, another club could go in there. Am I correct? I'm giving you guys another 100 years.
Yeah.
I'm going another 100, so.
The variance does run with the land, so
right.
if that were to happen, it would only be this type of club.
All right, that's what I want to make.
And Commissioner DeGray,
yes,
they would still need to come in front of you to get permission to get their
in
own alcohol.
In 100 years,
permit.
I don't think they'll be seeing me, but you know.
Everywhere I turn,
there's
an article saying we can extend your life to 100.
No, that's all right. I don't want to be another 100 years, but all right, I just wanted to make sure.
Yes, the variance runs with the land and another club.
Right. Well,
conceivably have the right to
here.
Come in front of whoever's there at the time and say, yeah.
Okay. Well, we've got new members, and I want to make sure they understand
Absolutely.
That a variance runs with the land and not with the club.
Correct. So. And it's limited to this space, though.
Yes.
Not for the whole building.
Not for the whole building. Thank
just
you.
Just this space, just this side.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. John, any questions for the applicants?
No, I don't have any. I certainly support the club and the location. I also don't have any issues with regard to the parking. I think we can certainly add a condition in there under site specific to, you know, for the applicant to use its best efforts to incorporate, you know, noise reduction and soundproofing to that site specific condition. So and certainly approve the three waivers that you're looking for as well. Thank you.
Commissioner Alinsky, any comments?
Comments?
Yes, a couple of things came to mind while I was listening to everyone's comments. As far as the noise abatement is concerned, I like the idea of having a requirement for them to use best effort to do noise abatement. But we have to remember that for many years, Enfield Pizza was in that location. So I'm wondering, you know, how much noisier is the Grays Athletic Club versus what Enfield Pizza was at that time? You know, so, and there were tenants there then. So seems to me they're probably not going to be much more noisy or any much noisier than Enfield Pizza would have been with all their activity going on. The second thing is as far as the parking is concerned, my understanding is that the Grays Athletic Club has a total of 80 members. And I think I saw in the write-up somewhere that there were about an average of 39 members attending on a daily basis. So you got 39 people, maybe some days on a snow day you don't even have. So it doesn't sound like there's a lot of people there. And that coupled with the fact that many of them are walkers, it sounds like the parking problem is not going to be a big issue. I just wanted to make those few points.
All set. John, you're all set?
I'm good, Frank.
Okay, thank you.
Sure.
So I guess it's my turn. So just looking at your schematic here. No kitchen? Because you had one. I used to eat in there. You had a kitchen one time.
We had a stove.
Yeah. Well, we used to eat in there. So no kitchen. It's just something I can't make out here. Lori, again, on the comments, the agency comments, you know, I'm a stickler on this. I see no concerns, no response, which is even more bothersome. I know in some cases they're going to have another bite at the apple relative to fire and health and the building department. But I'm just going forward, when I see this, I'm going to just move ahead and there's nobody that has any concerns. I mean, I really, you know, we have the art meetings and, you know, we should have answers. And, you know, the art meetings, I was on the other side when they kind of first developed. And the reason behind those art meetings were, so when the applicants came here, they were 95, 98% done. Everything is taken care of, so they don't have to keep coming here all the time. So I think I would like to emphasize that the art meetings nail everything. You know, not just talking about this one, but going forward, you know, when they come here, everything should be settled with the professionals, the staff, public safety, all the different representatives. And that really, I'll tell you, for me, that sways me on my decisions because they're the professionals, especially when it comes to health and safety. So I really would like to emphasize on that art meetings. So, you know, this is everybody, no response. And that's bothersome to me.
Okay.
It's not the first time I've mentioned it, but I'm hoping that, I don't know if it's a computer glitch. I heard that at one point, but I the fire department's definitely going to respond. It's there's people living upstairs. They're going to want to take a look at that, you know. So I know it's going to happen just because of the way the process works. But I'm telling you, going forward, no response is not good. So I appreciate if we, you know, take maximum advantage of the art meetings. Mm-hmm. And they were made so applicants come here for the shortest period of time possible. So that's my piece on it. As far as the liquor licenses in the area, you're right. We used to play this little game, all of us, and see if we could have a drink in every place in Thompsonville. So Billy may be, I mean, John may be able to help me on this. I think it was 25 or 30. We did it walking. We did it walking. That was between bars and clubs. I don't believe I ever made it. I don't think I ever finished. But
I think they call that a crawl now.
Yeah, well, we used to, between the clubs and the bars, it was 25 or 30 permits this side of Route 5. So, yeah, so, you know, we could have probably have another one. I mean, I don't think it's a problem. I'm curious, didn't you get the opportunity to put your license in abeyance? Or
yes, we did.
It's in suspension now, but.
Right. So you can't you just take it out? Why do you have to do this, is what I'm asking.
Oh, because.
The location?
Yeah, we since we're moving the location, okay. We need a new permit for the permit goes with the location. It
right.
Doesn't follow the permitting around.
But you have it, so it's not going to be a big.
Well, we still have to file some papers,
right.
You know, and Rick will have to sign off. Basically, we're asking you to give Rick permission to sign off on the application for this
okay.
New location. So.
Yeah, so you voluntarily suspended it, because I know they let you do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is helpful to the applicant. And so I have nothing else, so I'm sure, Lori, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, getting back to the ARTs, not everything has an ART, but everybody, every application does go out to the full staff, the extended staff, fire departments and health, for every application on OpenGov. We cannot make people respond. We've done our best to get people to respond, even if they have no comment, just say no comment. So we've actually worked on some glitches that have been occurring actually with the fire departments because they weren't getting the notices. Something had not been checked. So
getting
hopefully that's going to be better.
Fire department's getting them now?
Yes, okay. Yes, they are. As far as the parking, when I did the calculations, it was based on the overall square footage of the attendant space, and it's really only based on the patron area. So I couldn't take that. There was no scale on the plan, so I couldn't delete the bar area. So that would minimize the patron area. So actually, when I say 20 spaces, that's the maximum. Based on the overall tenant space, not the patron area. So it actually would be less. I just didn't know exactly how much less. I actually went out on Sunday night and did a little drive in Thompsonville because everybody's complaining about there's no parking and, you know, it's snowing. What happens when we snow? That parking lot had at least 12 spaces that were empty. So, I do believe that there is going to be adequate parking here. And then there's South Street, Oak Avenue, and King Street are also within walking distance. And then I just wanted one correction on the memo. The first motion to approve the waiver of section 8.120, that is the wrong reference, it's 9.10.2. And I think that was it. No, this is a.
Mr. Chair, if I could just add
sure.
To go along with the comment about the ART, I've obviously participated in many of mm-hmm. those meetings. I don't know that we would have asked for one in any event, but notwithstanding that, I really am grateful to staff because these guys been behind me have been waiting a year and a half. And get a new home, mm-hmm. and they were very anxious, and that was known to staff. I made it known to staff. Other people did. So I think that staff accommodated us in as quick a means as possible. Plus with the holidays and such, and I like going to ARTs. I think generally speaking, they're useful, but there wasn't one in this instance, and I don't think that I would have asked for one
right.
because of the delays. And plus, we're really not, mm-hmm. you know, it's really a question of getting permission to have the liquor permit and then the parking issues.
Yeah,
so.
And in this case, like I said, those yeah. particular people are going to get another bite at the apple.
Absolutely,
when the
right.
permitting process happens.
Sure.
So,
mm-hmm.
but overall, I think it's a good tool for you guys, you know, to get up there and iron things out with
right.
everybody before you come here. You know, and. I just think it's a good process.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, seeing that we have all our questions answered, I'm going to just have you guys step back, and I'm going to invite the public to come up. Any comments? Anybody in the public would like to speak for or against this application? Raise your hand and I'll call you up. Is there anybody that would like to come up and speak for or against? For the second time? Oh, ma'am. Yeah. You come up here, please, and identify yourself.
Sure.
Name and address for the record, please.
Okay, my name's Amanda Patel. May I
get the microphone?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Make sure the red light is on.
Sure. My name's Amanda Patel. I own 98 through 106 Pearl Street, and I just wanted to tell you that I am in support, not as a landlord, but as the purpose of the club, a nonprofit, long-standing, and just in general, good people. And that's exactly what we've been looking to fill this vacancy, because nobody wants a vacancy, but we don't want to just rush and allow anybody in there. So I think it was a great idea when they brought it to my attention, and I am in support of any of the process that you need.
Well, thank you very much for your comments.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that. Would anybody else like to come up and speak? For the second time? For the third time? I declare public communications closed. The applicants may come back up. Is there any more questions from the commission? I entertain a motion to close the public hearing.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, show of hands. I declare the public hearing closed. Thank you.
Mr. Chair, we have three waivers that we need to vote on individually, I guess.
I see them, yeah.
Before the motion, so I guess we'll just start, and let me read the first motion, or first waiver, that is. So I'd like to make a motion to approve the waiver of section 9.10.2 to eliminate the requirement for a site plan, since there are no proposed changes to the historical site.
Second.
Roll call.
Okay, Francis Alimo?
Four.
Four.
Linda DeGray?
Linda DeGray.
Ken
Hawatsky?
Four.
Vincent Grillo?
Vincent Grillo.
Four.
Joseph Neuwhite?
Four.
Terrence Lynch?
Four.
And John Petronella is four. Okay, the second waiver is as follows. Mr. Chair, I'd like to make a motion to approve on-street parking per section 8.124, note number 6, to allow up to 50% of off-site parking to be within 500 feet of the site.
Second.
Roll call. Any discussion on that? Is there any discussion? Roll call vote. Mr. Secretary, please.
Yeah, Francis Alimo?
Four.
Four.
Linda DeGray?
Linda DeGray.
Four.
Ken Hawatsky?
Ken Hawatsky.
Four.
Vincent Grillo?
Four.
Joseph Neuwhite?
Four.
Terrence Lynch?
Four.
And John Petronella is four.
Motion passes.
And the third waiver is I'd like to make a motion to approve the reduction of on-site parking to be 3 per section 8.124, note number 7, based on historical non-conforming nature of this site and available off-street parking lots and on-street parking within 500 feet of the property.
Second.
Discussion. I'm going to have a few words for this. I am definitely 100% in support of this application. I'm 100% in support of your organization, your club. I'm very familiar with it. You guys probably haven't seen me there, but many, many years ago, I spent a good amount of time in there. Everybody knows that I love Enfield, but I love Thompsonville a little bit more. So I'm very happy that you're staying in Thompsonville, and I'm glad that you're able to find a location. The fire was terrible, tragic, and you guys were there for such a long time. You got a great reputation. You give back to the society. You have great clam bakes. I don't know if you still have them anymore. But I'm going to be 100% in favor of this. Is there any more discussion on this last final motion to approve?
No, we still have one
more. No, that's three.
No, that's just a waiver.
Oh, okay. Well, I said it now. Okay, motion for the waiver. Roll call, Mr. Petronella.
Yep. Francis Alimo.
Four.
Francis Alimo.
Linda DeGray.
Four.
Linda DeGray.
Four.
Ken Holinsky.
Ken Holinsky.
Four.
Vincent Zerillo.
Four.
Joseph Smealway.
Four.
Terrence Lynch.
Four.
And John Petronella is four. And now is the motion to approve. Now, we're still talking about adding a site-specific condition with respect to noise reduction, so I'll make a proposed a site-specific condition to that. Mr. Chair, I'd like to make a motion to approve public hearing number 3085, 98 to 106 Pearl Street, application for special use permit to sell alcohol under a Class 5 public, club permit for section 8.122 use table, Gray's Athletic Association, Inc., applicant, Bree Rose, LLC, owner, map 24, lot 158, TD2 zone, with the following amendment to the conditions. Add under site-specific condition, it would read number 7 would be as follows. Applicant to use its best efforts to incorporate noise reduction and soundproofing to the renovations. And with that, there would be a total of 24 conditions with assigned to this proposal.
Second.
Discussion? Seeing none, roll call vote, Mr. Secretary?
Yep, Francis Alimo.
Four.
Four.
Linda DeGray.
Linda DeGray.
Four.
Four.
Kenneth Holinsky.
Kenneth Holinsky.
Four.
Vincent Grohl.
Vincent Grohl.
Four.
Joseph Mueller.
Four.
Terrence Lynch.
Four.
And John Petronella is four.
Mr. Chairman, members of the commission, we thank you very much. Just before I leave, congratulations.
Thank you.
Commissioner Alimo on your election as chair. And Mr. Grillo, happy to see you back. Thank you. I think we'll see you all soon.
Yes, congratulations, gentlemen, ladies. Good luck and big success. Good night. So moving on, old business.
Excuse me, can I ask one question?
Sure, it's out of order, but I'll let you. No, I'm sorry, you could have came up and spoke before, but
no,
we don't have.
Not about this, who is the fire
marshal? They have three of them now, I think. Scott moved away. Scott got a job out in Alaska.
I talked to Scott.
Yeah, I think, you know, he's got warm blood, I don't know, but he went to Alaska. Yeah, so I think right now they have some...
It's Kevin Peretz.
Oh, yes, that's right. Kevin's there now. Yes, Kevin Peretz. Okay. I forgot about that.
Which house was he working at?
Downtown in Thompsonville, yep.
Thank you very much all.
Yep, you're very welcome. Good night, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Old business. Any old business? No old business. Moving on to new business.
We just did new business.
Well, that was a move in the agenda again.
Yeah. We'll get there.
Yeah. This agenda was crazy tonight.
I guess.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Any other business properly come before said meeting? Is there any other business? Seeing none? Correspondence? We talked about that. It's up there. We're going to move that. That'll be different. Commissioners, we did that already. Planning staff report, we did that. See, the meeting ends quicker, you know, this way.
Yeah.
It's all done already.
Yes, the applicant sits there a little bit longer.
Yeah, but they get to hear some good stuff. Do we need to authorize any administrative approvals?
Not this evening.
Okay. And your applications to receive, we're going to keep it, we'll keep that in 20. Should have been.
I have a whole page of receipts.
Come on.
I'm not kidding.
I thought we were going to have time to do the zoning maps. We're never going to have time. You keep throwing all this work at us.
It's called economic development.
It's good to hear. I'm happy to hear.
Are the first stop.
Go ahead, Laura.
I'll go through this quick. PH 3086, 44 Laughlin Road, application for special use permit for an accessory apartment. Steve and Kellyanne Cardinal, owner, map 106, lot 5, R44 zone. PH 3087, 50 Weymouth Road, application for modification of a craft cafe liquor permit per section 490. Charles Masterbirdy, applicant owner, map 16, lot 111, R44. PH 3088ZA, 1297 Enfield Street, application for a zoning text amendment to allow housing for the elderly in HR 33 zone per section 4.20 and 4.40.3. Carl Landolina, applicant, Felician Sisters owner, map 46, lot 002, R33 zone, R33 zone and HR 33 zone. SPR 1926, 161 Raffia Road, application for site plan review for a proposed retail development. Garrett Homes LLC, applicant Mitchell Wajner, owner, map, it's a new lot, we didn't have the map lot yet, and BL zone. SPR 1927, 210 Moody Road, application for site plan review for self-storage development. Top Knot LLC, applicant owner, map 100, lot 11, I-1 zone. SPR 1928, 120 Post Road, application for site plan review for solar system and carport array. Green Earth Roofing Systems LLC, applicant John Dowd, owner, and map 47, lot 45, I-1 zone. And finally, SPR 1929, 525 Enfield Street, application for site plan modifications from PH number 3058, 525 Enfield Street, LLC, applicant owner, map 33, lot 263 through 267 in the BG zone. So we got some applications coming up.
So they're going to be spread out over a couple of agendas.
Yes, so. Yes, absolutely. Nope, we're going to hear that.
We'll hit the time limit.
No, yeah, absolutely. They're going to be spread out over the next two meetings.
Okay. That Enfield Street, was that car wash we approved in the gas station?
So that's actually Ardioli Dodge.
Oh, okay.
The building, we reviewed and approved that application last February.
Yeah.
And they want to do some modifications to the site plan now that they've got the building up.
Good. Okay. Work in progress.
There you go.
All righty. So do I get a...
Make a motion to adjourn?
Second.
All right. Second. All in favor? Show of hands.
Walter,
well,
B.
thank
Jeff.
You for your patience tonight, everybody. I hope I did my
great.
Best, and I appreciate your patience.
You
thank
did
you very
great,
much.
Frank.
Thank you, John. Thank you.